Okay, are we in this thing? Is the melanin on? Yes, it is. Hey, what's up, everybody? This is your girl, Miss P. I hope you are doing fantastic. I am doing well. It is time for another review. Make sure to go ahead and like this video, thumbs it up, turn your notifications on. This way you know whenever I'm dropping another video. And I hope y'all are doing well during this Rona, honey. It's another week. Yeah, it's another week. And honey, I was doing okay. But then when I realized that my nails were growing out, I was like, you know what? I started scratching myself. And then I was like, you know what? This hair ain't gonna last. Like, it's just a lot. But keep me lifted up in prayer. One thing that I have been doing, I've been staying busy, okay? I've been doing a lot of household stuff, honey. I've been painting outside doors and all that type of shit today. Like, I have really been doing it. I've been doing a lot of good, positive habits, you know? So I'm excited about that. But, you know, some things, honey, I just can't wrap my head around. But it's another week in a row, honey. Down below in the comment section, let me know how you're doing, honey. Let me know, okay? I'm going to bring back the shout-outs next week. I'm going to definitely comment back to you guys before I do the shout-outs. I'm going to pick out some of my favorite comments, and next week I'll be back. So get it popping. Down below, you have one more week this week to comment down below. Let me know how you're doing and comment on this video, okay? But thank y'all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I have been, like I said, trying to stay as active as possible. But thank you so much for checking out these videos. And yeah, let's go ahead and get into this review, honey. Baby, the cast of Love & Hip Hop, they in quarantine too. All these celebrities, child. It's crazy seeing these people houses, okay? It's nuts. But either way, they're doing their confessional interviews at their house. Like, it's not how it usually is. And I was like, I didn't know they do their confessionals the week of. Like, that's real crazy. But either way, when I saw Mimi talking about, yes, this is my house behind me, I was like, oh, but everybody's little quarantine situation was just interesting. So yeah, this episode starts out Mimi, being that she's gone through a lot in her life, she wants to have a self-defense class. So all the ladies are at the self-defense, which I think is dope. You know, I love me a good old I love me a good old boxing. I don't know why I just thought of Martin Kendi, but I love me a good old boxing self-defense situation, and everybody need to know how to get somebody. I might be little, okay? But don't push me. Okay, so we have a new chick that they're adding to the cast, Kiyomi. And I was like, where do I know her from? She was on Love & Hip Hop. Not Love & Hip Hop. Growing Up Hip Hop. Her and Bow Wow were in a relationship situation and it went bad. Like, it was a lot of violence. It was real toxic. It was crazy. I was like, what the hell? Lil Bow Wow? Damn! He big Bow Wow. Now, it's a lot. You know, you think of these child stars and you're like, no! And you forget that they're human. You see these people on TV, you see all of this stuff, and you forget that they're human until, honey, we all going through the pandemic, okay? Carly's there. I keep looking at Carly and I'm going, why did she get her face done? Like, Carly, it's beautiful. Like, why didn't she get you? She didn't get her face done. I think it was the lips. So now they're like this, like even, I can't. And honey, I don't like talking about people and their surgeries or whatever they've done and want to feel better about themselves, but So Carly's introducing Kiyomi and Shekinah and Spice are like, God, where I know her from? And Shekinah, I love Shekinah, but I can't stand her. Even during this quarantine, I've been checking out Shekinah's IG lives in the morning. I just love her. But either way, she was like, yeah. You were the girl, I don't know, beating up Bow Wow. Well, Bow Wow beating up on you, whatever. Something happened. That was you. Kiyomi was like, don't do that. And I was like, yeah, don't. Just say, girl, you do look familiar. Like, a people child anyway. But Shekinah, she has no filter. So, I mean, and granted, baby girl, what were you expecting, baby girl? What were you expecting, Puddin'? Oh my God, that was terrible in her confessional how she was saying, you know what, she's been used to domestic violence, you know, growing up seeing it, and she thought that that was love. And the crazy thing, well, it's not crazy. People believe that that is love. That is something that you have to go through. Whether it's emotional, physical, like all of it is the same shit. Like, you do not have to go through that to be loved and to feel loved. I can understand. Like, it's crazy. Like, what you will accept and what you think is okay. You know what I'm saying? And even when you get something different, it takes you a while to really untangle yourself from the toxicity. It's crazy. But honey, please move forward, Kiyomi. That's what she was saying she wanted to do. But then I figured out, I knew who you gonna try to move forward with. Shoot her ass. You trade one for the other. Child, I can't. Speaking of Shooter and Scrap, they want to go into Biz Nye together. And I think that's good. You know, people, I'm never going to say don't start no business. Why are you doing that? What you want to do that for? Do better, be better, stay out of the jail cell. There you go. Okay, Cheyenne, who is Scrap's sister. Okay, Scrap De Leon. she is messing around with Shooter. They've been messing around for the past 2 years. They've been secret lovers, okay? The only thing is, Shooter is the one that's saying, oh, we want to keep this under wraps. We don't want to talk about this. Like, we just messing around. And she's sitting here like, no. I want to be your, lover. Like, she is ready to go. And she's like, no. Don't even kiss me out here. What are we doing? I said, oh, Cheyenne. He's talking about, let's not rush this. It's been 2 damn years. What are you talking about? No, absolutely not. She talking about, I've been holding you down for 2 years. That's something I would just want to yank Cheyenne and say, girl, do you know who you are? I don't even know who you are, but you get your life together. Talking about, I've been holding this nigga down for 2 years. Go, you better go to bed. You better go to bed, wake up, and try again. Absolutely not. I say, if somebody don't want to love you for you, you're doing everything that you do in a relationship, out and about, in public, in the open. Everything's out in the open, Johnny Taylor. You better get your ass out of there, okay? Because if they don't want to love you in public, you shouldn't just have me in the sheets. Absolutely not. Have a great damn day. I'm sitting here looking at Shooter like, do you understand that you're on camera? Shooter, I don't understand these people. They want to do all of this and they don't realize that they're being recorded. You talking about, I love you. I mean, it sounded like bullshit. I said, bullshit. That's what it sounded like. It was like it wasn't the normal bullshit. It was like a nice level of like a Grey Poupon, like bullshit. That's what it sounded like. Cause I said, Shooter, you full of shit. You didn't even look in now when you said that, talking about, I love you. Like, it's the biggest crock of bullshit on earth. And granted, maybe Shooter loves her for her. Maybe he loves how she make her peanut butter and jellies. Maybe he loved how she did her hair that day. I don't know. Because people will say, I love you. And throw that ass in the circle. They'll throw that shit in a circle. And have people be like, oh my God, he loved me. No, he didn't mean it like that. Maybe he, because I love you is loaded. Like, I don't know if you guys understand. It's like a loaded baked potato. I love you is loaded. You can have it all the way. You can have it just a little bit. Like, it just depends. And people love to throw that I love you around. Like, it's just, I love you. Oh, my God. Like, just like, hey, friend. Like, people love to throw those words around like it's nothing. And it's like, that is something. You got to be careful. Here go, she says she the queen of Atlanta. And I'm sick of hearing that. They even titled this Queen of Atlanta. I was like, how, Sway? How do we deem who is Queen of Atlanta? How do we know this? Light skin Keisha and Akbar are beefing. I'm like, where does the beef? What's beef? Where does this beef start? Like, why can't we all just get along? What are we doing? Akbar talking about she trying to come for the throne. Girl, nobody is trying to come for the invisible throne. Honey, the way Jack had on all of his jewels in a three-piece suit for his confessional in the living room, I was done. I couldn't take it. Jack says he's gonna set it up for Akbar to call in when light skin Keisha comes in for her interview. I say, you know what, that's not, you know, that might be a good idea, but I don't know how that's gonna work. Oh, I couldn't take it when Akbar said that light skin Keisha was a blowfish looking bitch. How did they come up with this stuff? I was done. But then I had to think, what does a blowfish look like? And I was finished. I said, who comes up with this? Why? Come on, Tokyo, with the weight loss journey. Talking about she gonna ride the bicycle like she be riding her man. I said, girl, you better be happy. Tokyo is excited about that dick, okay? Excited. So, of course, she had to tell her best friend, Light Skin Keisha, what Akbar was saying. And, of course, Light Skin Keisha was like, what the hell? Light Skin Keisha, I told y'all, she's one of my favorites. I enjoy her. I enjoy the antics with her and Coca. I enjoyed them, especially on their YouTube channel. But when she was in that confessional, talking about Akburger, I was dead, deceased. Make me an obituary, Mama D. I was done. But either way, I also had to say, I enjoyed how Light Skin Keisha was presented on her confessional. She looked real cute. Loved it. A celebration of scrap being free. Outside, Cheyenne said it was a 1 year liberation. I was like, y'all can come up with some shit. Like, what you going to, girl? A 1 year liberation party? Oh, okay. Like, doesn't that sound good? Yeah. Doc sees Carly at the bar and he goes over to talk to her. He puts his head on her shoulder. She said, ooh. Carly wants no interaction, no nothing with Jack. She said, honey, it's a 3-second rule. You hugged me far too long. Like, no. I don't even want you to touch me. Don't even breathe the same air. Like, she was practicing social distancing before we even needed to do it. I was done. I'm finished. Jack is just always going to be too much. I'm going to pray for Jocelyn and Kendra. I'm praying for them and their union. I hope they make it last forever, Keith Sweat. Because, honey, Jack, I never see him changing. I just don't. I'm sorry. People can change, but woo. We go with Kiyomi, right? she wants to be known for stuff other than, you know, the elevator situation. She wants to be known for her music, I'm thinking. I don't know, or modeling, whatever she's doing. But either way, we see her all slobbed up in a shower. I said, oh, hell no. It was Shooter, because I was like, who else got the dreads? Come to find out, it was a photo shoot type of thing. I said, woo, thank you, Jesus, because if this is what I'm looking at, I don't want to see it. You remember how you used to be little and you see a nasty scene and you be like this? I didn't want to see it. Well, I kind of wanted to see it, but then I didn't want to see it. Then she had nerve to ask him, you babysitting today? I'm sitting here like, those are his children. He is not babysitting. He is taking care of them children. That's what his ass should be doing. But anyway, I was like, Kim, woo, child. Sitting here like, hold up. Are they together? Were you just the prop, Shooter? No, Shooter was not a prop because he was a little bit too invested. And then I was like, okay, are you and Shooter together? Or is it you and Cheyenne? And then Shooter in his confessional said, you know what? It's an open relationship. So I really don't feel no type of way, you know, about Cheyenne. But at the same time, Kiyomi, like, that's my favorite. I really see a relationship with her. And I'm sitting here like, bullshit. That's what I told y'all. Y'all remember the bullshit I told you about? Yes. He ends up telling Kiyomi that he's 41, you know. Well, she knew that, I guess. But he was like, even though I'm 41, like, you know, I'm dim. Too damn old to be playing those reindeer games. I'm sorry. After a certain age, I'm going to say for a man, after the age of 40, you need to cut it out. Cut the shit. Like, you getting old. Like, you got to cut the game. You got to cut it out. You gotta cut it. And for a female, we mature faster than men do. So I'm saying for a female after the age of 35, you need to calm all the way down. You need to be like, what in the hell am I doing? Like, But I have to say, we're in the age of fuck shit. Y'all know what I'm talking about. People can just be on some fuck shit all the time. We're in the age of fuck shit, and people think, fuck my age, fuck experience, fuck all this shit. I can do whatever the hell I want. And that's why people get away with doing fuck shit all the time, because it's tolerable. We gotta stop this. It matters an open relationship. Ain't no damn open relationship if people don't know it's open. Time for the family dinner with Scrap Deb. Ciao. Not Scrap DeLeon. Lil Scrappy. The Bambi. Cece. Ernest. Imani. Little baby Brandon Bryan, whatever the hell his name is. And Mama D. I could not take it how Mama D showed up like she just left. I mean, she a whole funeral, honey. Like, they put the body in the ground. She went to the repast, and the repast was there, and this is it. That's what it looked like. Mama D and Ernest went to go get their plates, right? And then Cece was like, hey, D. Mama D didn't say shit. I was like, you petty. You're very petty for that, because she's at least tried to speak. At least try to be civil. Mama D wants no parts of it at all. Mama D can't stand Cece. Cece said that Mama D was fake, and she was like, because you wish death on me. And Mama D was like, I still wish death on you. You are Casper the Ghost right now, honey. I don't see you. You still dead. I said, yikes. They keep arguing. And the one thing I heard was Mama D say, you need to be in a cage. I... finishing move. I was done. Hold up. What really, really finished it for me was how she came and had the obituaries and one of them manila envelopes, child. I could not take it. Like, she had printed like 100 of them, like, to pass out around Atlanta. Like, I'm wondering, where did she go to get this done? Office Depot? Like, where did they print this? Who does that? Talk about in love. Was it even in love and memory, celebrating the life of? It was too much. And she had a picture of a child. That's what really threw me off, because Cece was like, I was done. I was very deceased. All of them were like, even Cece was like, you are sick. I was like, she is sick. Because who does that? Who thinks about doing some shit like that? I was done. Even Scrappy was like, you know what? Take my mic off, because this, I'm not a part of. Y'all crazy. You want to keep filming this? You want to see me go crazy? That's when I knew, okay, this shit isn't really like for the cameras. Because this, well, it was for Mama D, but Scrappy them, they were like, mm-mm, this is too much. We just came for some chitlins and rice, honey. Y'all crazy. It's a give back situation. KK wants to talk to Cheyenne because she's seen her and Shooter give googly eyes and shit, and she's like, and I know Scrap DeLeon don't know about this. So she goes over to Cheyenne and was like, what y'all doing? Cheyenne said, and it's serious between her and Shooter. I said, that don't sound like no open relationship to me. It sounds like this is very closed. Serious how? Even KK was like, mm-mm, you messy. Ain't no way. I'm with KK on this one. I'm rarely with KK on a lot of things, but I was like, messy. Something ain't right. We go to the studio. They're doing an interview with Light Skin Keisha, Jock, and the other girl. I think her name was Jazzy. Can't remember, but either way, they're doing the interview. Everything's going fine until Light Skin Keisha says she is the queen of Atlanta. And then they both looking like, Earth? And Jock was like, this is a perfect time for me to bring in my guest. She's on the TV right there. Akbar. And Keisha was like, oh, hell no. I'm ambushed. I don't like this. She packs up. I mean, gets her winter coat and she walks on out. They both like, what? Even Akbar's looking like, Akbar was like, look, when you can push a pin, don't need no ghostwriter, then you can be the queen of ATL. Like, you can compete with a real bitch because you ain't no real bitch. I was like, oh my God. Light-skinned Keisha just wanted to get her parking validated, honey. And then she was like, you know what? Balenciaga, look at me, bitch. I ain't... And I was like, you know what? This is too much. First of all, Jack, why did you do that? Okay. Even though he did see that her and the Bambi could talk and, you know, there wasn't no pause put on nobody. But at the same time, I was looking at light-skinned Keisha like, you know what? That was a good time, you know, to talk. But at the same time, I can see why she felt ambushed. Would I have liked that done to me? No, I would have preferred, even though she kind of did it with Bambi. But, you know, I don't know what I would prefer in that situation. I don't like being ambushed. I don't like it when people do that. So I can side with Keisha on that one and say, you know what? You could have gave her a heads up. I see that. But Jock, I see what he did. He was trying to be a Shekinah. But at the same time, I feel like he was doing that in a petty way. It wasn't like so they could really come together. So that's just my opinion, though. And Akbar, she's just no guns blazing, don't care. And I really feel like Akbar could give Light Skin Keisha a run for her money in the talking department. We'll see. But in the future, on the next episode or the episode after that, I really do think we need to see them talk. I really do. But that was the episode. Down below in the comment section, I would love to know, what did y'all think about this episode of Love and Hip Hop? How are you handling this week of the Rona and the quarantine? Let's talk about it down below. Like I said, I'm going to be commenting back to you guys in the comment section from episode 1 to now, and I'm going to pick out some of my favorite comments for the shout out. So get it popping down below in the comment section, because I just might pick your comment. But thank you guys so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. And I will see you on the next video. Peace, love, and all that good stuff. God bless. Be safe, guys. Bye.